Welcome back, Zero K fans, to another exhibition match. This time, Flipstit versus Ball of Doom on Living Lands. And Orphelius was apparently excited in chat, so I'm curious what happens here. Flipstit going for Spider Factory, Ball of Doom going for a Cloakybud Factory. Wow, a lot of early glaives too. Ball of Doom being very aggressive. No early worker. Flipstit also going very aggressive. Both players are thinking, well, this map is tiny. I'm going to be aggressive. I mean, this map is kind of tiny. Of course, we have the center expansion that's kind of hard to hold, but usually players go here and here. The corner ones, the ones over the southeast and northwest corners of the center, those aren't usually taken. And usually, of course, the corners are taken. The players will expand along the sides. Like, south player usually expands along to the southeast, north player to the northwest. But at this point, I have no idea what's going to happen because both players are being very aggressive. Ball of Doom now finally getting their workers up, but very early glaive. They want to deal some damage. Of course, with the Venom in play, that won't happen very easily. Good micro should allow for it, but this is going to be very difficult. Just because glaives get stunlocked so easily by Venom, and as soon as they get close to each other, that's going to be it. That Venom splash damage is going to take it out. Like, right now! Yeah, that's not going to work. There really isn't a number of glaives to beat Venom like that. Venom pretty much just stops glaives in their tracks. So Ball of Doom with an early donation to Flipstip. The Flipstip Construction Foundation definitely appreciates the donation. It'll send a fruit basket in the mail as thanks. And once again, Ball of Doom continuing to be very generous to Flipstip. Figuring that Flipstip just simply does not have enough metal, and Ball of Doom obliging, giving them a bit more. However, at the same time, Ball of Doom is expanding over to the center, so they are covering their attack. Sorry, they are covering their expansion with an attack. That's what you should do. That's what they're doing. Very well done. You want to make sure that you have, like, when you're attacking, that's a great time to expand, because your opponent's under pressure. They're not going to be counterattacking, most likely. I mean, they might afterwards, but especially if they're defending up a bit, expanding is the best way to go. Just don't naked expand, necessarily. On a map this size, no. Especially when your opponent is Spider and they could have Fleas anywhere and know exactly where you're expanding and decide to go for it at the perfect timing. Because Spiderbot Factory is the ambush factory. The Ball of Doom, though, really ahead in economy right now. They've got double the metal and the energy to match. Flipstip building up to the center. They're now building up to the center, but it's slower. Ball of Doom, on the other hand, kind of going a bit idle. Why are they building up here? Okay, getting a defender up. Not a bad idea. Getting warriors up. There we go. Though, surprisingly, Ball of Doom not building a whole lot of units. They should be. Either build units or build something. They're about to excess metal. It's not what they want to do. Flipstip, on the other hand, continuing to build their army up. Got weavers up as well, so they are going to be going for their expansion attempts as well. Well, getting reclaim and then expansion. Looks like... No, Ball of Doom is not reclaiming these rocks at all. Or the trees. But certainly not the rocks. Ball of Doom without a whole lot to work from having their economy fall apart. They did have the defender, but only in the north side. That's not enough. Flipstip's commander, though, walking into its own grave. Yeah, it's jumping headlong to its own grave. Flipstip loses their commander right off the bat. 3.5 minutes into the game. When it's actually a meaningful loss. Like, that wasn't nothing. That was actually a problem. And losing most of their army, too. Ball of Doom getting to a very nice start here. I mean... Ball of Doom is, unfortunately, accessing metal. If they weren't accessing metal, that would be fine. But yeah, that nice center positioning there. I guess Flipstip did not expand there to be that much... Or expect there to be that much build up in the center... Their commander just went for it. Didn't work out, but went for it. Still, Flipstip not too far behind. That was a blow, but Weavers are in position. They do have radar, so they know at least what's going on. But yeah, Flipstip needs to get built up quickly. They have, okay, the eastern side, that's good. They have that. They know what's coming over here, so the flea can at least deal, or they do, right? Yes, the flea does see, oh no, it doesn't. The conjurer not yet building. Looks like it might be screening for fleas first. Didn't find anything, so Flipstiff not really aware until just now. Okay, the flea does see it. When is the reaction going to happen? Keep an eye on that one, because that is going to be a big deal when that happens. Ah, there we go. Going for that harassment, and the Conjurer cannot get out of the way. The Defender will not be built up in time. Nice harassment there by Flipstiff. Ball of Doom still ahead in economy, but that is a good move. The flea... Oh, can it get... I can't get this in time. The flea needs to run. Flipstiff does not know this. Gonna just go for it anyway. It's gonna die, but... Oh, just barely. If it moved a touch. If it had moved just here, the exact spot, it would have been fine. It would have gotten that one extra hit. So close to killing that metal extractor. So painfully close. But Ball of Doom still ahead in economy. That's the thing. That harassment didn't really work super well. It worked a bit, though. It slowed down the expansion. Bit of a tempo loss. Flipstep able to get that north expansion built up. Continuing along to the south as well. So Flipstep didn't quite manage to get the economy. Did stop the expansion from continuing, though. This would have been considerably more built up. It would have been two metal extractors, a couple lotuses. The Conjurer would have been continuing over to the southeast right now. It would have been a different story. Flipstep wouldn't be quite so able to take out the southeast right now. So still a good move. Getting rid of the Conjurer, good move. Now Flipstep making sure that they themselves have also expanded and set up their own expansions, the North expansion there. But their economy remains behind. Which is kind of curious. Ball of Doom, they have three... That's some overdrive, but all they really have, like, six here, another six here, that's 12. 14. Plus four for the commander's 18. Oh, they also have this expansion over here. Yeah, that's 21. Yeah, okay, that makes sense. Flipstep about to catch up, though. Once they get the southeast corner, that will be caught up. And if Ball of Doom can get rid of this Venom... Proving to be a bit of a challenge, though, if it manages. But yeah, this is not working out easily. Not a bad army composition to deal with what Flipstep has going, but Ball of Doom still not quite able to push in, and Flipstep's going to be able to take the southeast relatively easily, and the northwest with no trouble. I don't think Ball of Doom is even aware that the northwest is being taken. Well, they should... No, the radar shadow is right in the radar shadow. They just can't see it. The radar were a bit closer to the edge, it would be perfect, but the radar over here is getting blocked off by the terrain. And Ball of Doom, they're going to go... Okay, now they're going for the southeast. Take that out. Are they going to take it out? It looks like they should be able to, but there really aren't enough Roccos. The Venoms can just dodge it too easily. And attempts to support getting softened up a little bit, but working out fine. Flipstep able to pull in some fire support. And nice reclaiming, too. That's one thing that Ball of Doom is not doing. They are not reclaiming over here. That's 150 metal. That's not nothing. Flipstep's reclaiming this as well. Yeah, there's a lot being reclaimed here that Flipstep's taking that Ball of Doom is not. Getting Flipstep the advantage, but Ball of Doom going for a gunship plant. No real response yet. What? An Athena? Okay, very quickly getting artillery. Want to make up for the last game having no artillery. Well, the last game we saw. Not the last game played, but still. It's like, well, we had no artillery last game. Now we're having specifically built artillery from the Athena, which... Like, you never see the Athena being built. That's just not a unit that's built. Like, all it does is build other units. It's a good unit. It's cloaked. It allows for interesting harassment strategies, but it's 500 metal. And, it's a bit of a weird setup. At any rate... Flipstep still pretty able to secure the southwest. The Zeus is doing a job, not doing it unfortunately for them especially well, getting stunned out. Really, it's backfiring. The Venom is just stunning out everything. Zeus is doing their best shot, but really the Hermits can just take it all out. And now with the Hermits, with the Venom gone, the Hermits are now kind of hooped. Should be a couple Zeus deaths though. Oh, is this Zeus gonna die? It's... Nope. Or maybe, oh okay, one Zeus down, but still. That cracked that open. Ball of Doom cracked Flipstep open in the southeast side of the map. The Impaler trying to crack open the center, and a Black Dawn coming in. Okay, that's not what I expected. You do not see that very often. And Northwest also getting attacked. Not going to work out quite so well, though. Actually, it might work out okay. The Zeus... Ooh, is it going to get... No, it's not really getting a lockdown. But still opened it up. So the Northwest is also kind of open. The Southeast, however, torn apart. Ball of Doom should have gone to the South... Actually, Southeast, take out the expansion. Black Dawn coming in, getting stunned out, not working at all. And the Tarantula is not even going to be bothered with. Hermit, Venom, Recluse. That Black Dawn didn't do anything. Killed the Impaler. Okay, did one thing. 900 metal for 7. Okay, actually, that was value. When you consider the first Impaler. Because Athena's like 1200 for the Athena and the Impaler. But the Athena's not dead. So that was a very... That was still a Pyrrhic victory. That's not really value. It's like it's almost value. It's sort of a fake value. Monopoly value. It doesn't really actually mean anything. So yeah, bit of a problem there. Especially given all the donation metal there. Yeah, this is starting to fall apart for Ball of Doom. The Brawler's a better idea. The Brawler's a much better idea. They should be able to tear apart most of what's going on in the Southeast with that. Possibly also the Northwest, but I think they're more concerned with the Southeast. They've already tried to expand. Ball of Doom has already tried to expand to the Southeast. Because successfully expanded to the Northwest. But I'm pretty sure Ball of Doom wants the Southeast gone. And they're about to get their wish. And okay, was that a... I must have been a Brawler kill, right? Oh, no. The Stinger killed it. Oh, that must have been a move instead of a fight move command. Because there's no other reason why the Impaler would get that close. At any rate, why are these Zeuses not moving? Ball of Doom should be moving these Zeuses in to get... There we go. They should be moving them in. Get rid of this expansion. There are more than enough Zeuses to tear apart the rest of the Southeast. Where's the Conjurer backup? There should be a Conjurer right behind all this stuff. Where's... Okay, there's one... Okay, all the Conjurers are in the center and Northwest. That's not going to work out. You need one in the Southeast to expand there. And get right behind your military. Expand there. Build that back up. Because Ball of Doom's economy, it's falling behind. And Flipstep going for yet another Black Dawn. Why are they going for more Black Dawns? I don't understand the logic behind that.
I don't. It's just weird.
At any rate, Ball of Doom is managing to get some harassment. And they're taking things out on all ends. It's just, they're not paying attention. They're letting stuff get idle. It's like they're trying to attack on multiple fronts without actually maintaining an attack on multiple fronts. Which is a bit of an issue. Not to be rude, but it's a bit of an issue. Because now that Brawler just went down to... I had to retreat, I guess. Nope, got taken out. Taken out by the Razor. Looks like on the way of retreating. Southeast not really being attacked much. The center being assaulted heavily by Flipstep. Ball of Doom still able to hold, but... I don't know. The Black Dawn's a bit of a weird move for that. Kind of agree with the Aegis move, though. Kind of. And I say that because, as I mentioned before... Shields don't block fire that they can't block. Like, they don't partially block fire. If they don't have enough power to block a shot, they won't block the shot. And Aegis, just being a large area shields, they have more to block. Now, in this case, it's not a big deal. The Impaler would hit it anyway. But, yeah, in general, area shields are a bit risky for that reason. They just take a lot of hits from everything. And with only 50 shield regen per second is not a huge amount. And once again, that is really weird. Oops, sorry. That is a really weird thing that the Impaler is doing. It should be fight moving, not moving. Whatever, Crab coming in. Proper heavy attack artillery, well, semi-artillery coming in here. And the Sharpshooter as well. Wait, when did Ball of... Oh, Athena, right, of course, because Athena can build sharpshooters, or specters now. And Black Dawn trying to take out the Northwest. I don't know, I just don't get the logic behind Black Dawn. It's the reload rate is so terrible for it, unless you know exactly what you're going to hit. and you make sure to hit it correctly, it's suicide. I mean, that Black Dawn needs repair, but at this point, more Zeus, more Rocko's hammer's coming in as well, so at least that'll help get rid of the stinger up in the back from Flipstip. But Flipstip with the crab should be able to power through. Actually, no. No, they're not going to be able to power through. This Ball of Doom will probably, well, they might push in. Not sure if they realize they, with all the Zeuses they have, they should be able to push in. I mean, at this point, Ball of Doom is actually taking out a lot. They've taken out most of what's going on in the southeast. They need to re-expand in the southeast. Taking out most of the northwest, but haven't really expanded there to take it over. Ball of Doom has territory. They've got that going for them hard. So at this point, Ball of Doom just needs to be able to push in, and I don't think Black Dawns are the way to go for that, but apparently they do, so we'll have to see. I mean, enough Black Dawns will work. It's just, I don't know if it works for value. It's good for splash damage. Should be able to take out their hermits, or at least groups of things. Just don't know. Really not confident about the value here. But some scouting coming in here. Ball of Doom will be able to figure out exactly what's going on. Not that lay of it. Although, they do have radar, don't they? Yeah, they got radar. They have vision. They know what's going on. Okay, so they know exactly what's going on now. They got that sorted out. So at this point, Flipstip going forward. Probably a mistake. Ball of Doom, now that Flipstip's gone in their territory, has the confidence to move forward and probably take out something. They should be able to stun out the crab, actually. That many Zeuses? Or at least stun out the hermits that are supporting it. The Zeuses just need to be apart from each other. And Black Dawn coming in, I don't agree with it for crab. I agree with it for the hermits, not for the crab, but it'll do okay. I just personally would have gone for the brawler. But hey, it works out nonetheless, so how about that? Unfortunately, one of the Black Dawns goes down thanks to that Spectre. Has a rough landing, but still, Ball of Doom has cracked Flipstip open. This might be the last attack here. Flipstip going to try to do what they can to deal with this, but this looks to be pretty much the last attack. I mean, this is something, all right, but this is going to work. Black Dawn's coming in here. Extra support, nice extra support. I don't think there's a whole lot that Flipstip has going on here. Another Scorpion coming, or a Scorpion coming up. 30 seconds left. Those Zeuses will find it before it's finished. They won't kill it before it's finished. They will find it, though. Oh, they'll definitely... Okay, yeah, this is actually... It's kind of falling apart. The Weaver's forced to retreat. Not working out at all. Why are they not building up the Scorpion? The Scorpion's like the one hope. And no, Flipstip throwing even that away. Realizing there's not much to be said. Although, 7 seconds left, this might just work. Scorpion up, and is this going to go? Well, at least it stunned out the Zeuses. But honestly, Flipstip lost so much territory in the process of that. Can the Scorpion pull it back? They have 30 metal, they have a lot of reclaim. Flipstip might be able to pull this back in. Ball of Doom accessing, but so is Flipstip. Flipstip not building any more support units at the moment. They really need to do that. But they have a Cloaked Assault unit. They have that. It's something. Scuttle coming in to get rid of that Scorpion. Bit overkill, I'd say. I'm pretty sure that everything they have so far will at least be able to take care of the Scorpion soon enough, but looks like Ball of Doom just wants it gone ASAP. They do not want any risk there at all. I don't know if they know where the Scorpion is, though. I mean, if they realize where the Scorpion was, where it stopped. Ball of Doom with a bit of extra harassment, though. No Venoms in play to deal with this. Not much, really. There's a Lotus. That's about it. There's a Lotus. Not going to do much. And the fusion plant, oh, if that goes down, that's actually going to be really bad for Ball of Doom. Because those glaives are going to all die. Well, that's the harassment mission over. Yeah, don't attack fusion plants unless you make sure that all of your units are away from it. Or it's the last thing you attack, or its explosion will cause a chain reaction that will destroy most of your opponent's base entirely. None of those things were true. Flipstip had placed that fusion plant in a pretty safe position, all things considered. I mean, really, they lost a Lotus, but overall, they didn't lose anything. I mean, other than the fusion. The fusion was a loss. But Flipstip has enough energy to use the Reclaim. They're good. They're still pretty solid. However, Ball of Doom, I mean, they're good for their energy. Ball of Doom, however, just has all the territory. I mean, Flipstip has no tempo left. If Flipstip takes care of these Zeuses, there is a chance. Should have okay, D-Gun's up. No, I got rid of three of them. That's good, but now the Scuttle knows where to go. Where is that Scuttle? There it is. Scuttle's at the ready. And the Fleas did not spot it. Nice screening wall, though. Flipstip did get that set up. That was good to have. And, okay, Scorpion just out of Scuttle death range. Scuttle deals 8,000 damage to the Scorpion at 12,000 health. Well, 9,000 current health. They are safe. But still, Scuttle's bad. You don't want to have that Scuttle hit if you can avoid it. And Flipstip not paying attention to the Northwest, letting Ball of Doom take that Northwest, put a Lotus there, take it over. This is not working well for Flipstip. I mean, we can kind of tell that, but Flipstip, they're holding strong. I gotta say, they are doing a nice job. This Scorpion is at least giving them a lot of firepower to at least defend themselves, rebuild. It's a wall they can build behind. I mean, at this point, really, territory is a problem, but they have a lot of reclaim to work with. I mean, just within their base, well, within the safe part of their base, they have 500 metal. That should last them for about 2 or 3 minutes, if they're reclaiming a bunch of it. That will last them a decent amount of time. How many Scuttles are there? There are two Scuttles. The second one being constructed. That's where the problem lies. And Gnats as well to try to stun out the Scorpion. And Gnats, oh, stunning out the Glaives, but not stunning out the Black Duns. The Scorpion stunned out. The Scuttle's coming in for the kill. One Scuttle, not quite down. And the Scorpion will die there. Oh no, the Scuttle didn't hit. Scuttle did not manage to land that, weirdly enough. Another Black Dawn down. Ball of Doom just donated a couple units. That Scuttle did not work. That is a shame for Ball of Doom. That Scuttle had worked. That'd have been game. Flipstip would probably have thrown in the towel. Not much more to be said. But the Scorpion remains alive. That's one Scuttle dead. There's another one still up. That's 550. That's like, that was about 2,000 metal between the Scuttle. Actually, no, more than that. That was 2,400 metal, roughly, just for the Scuttle and the two Black Dawns. All inside of Flipstip's territory. And not sure why the anti-air. Ball of Doom going for a bunch of gremlins, but I don't know why. Flipstip has not made any mention of air. They haven't pointed anything in the direction of, I'm building air. I mean, granted, at this point, you kind of expect it. It's kind of surprising, but still. There's really been no indication of any air coming up. There's no funnel web, so no drones. Jumpbot Factory coming in as well, probably for Firewalker. Firewalker assist is basically what you use the Jumpbot for, unless you're actually specifically going for Jumpbot. I mean, we saw Ball of Doom went for the Scuttle assist call, which makes sense given the anti-heavy, but Flipstip has to deal with all this defenses, so we're going to see Firewalkers pretty soon. Crab coming up as well for a little bit of extra firepower, and also another nice Scuttle target. I mean, side note for those not aware, when the Crab is in position, when it's stopped, it has effectively 12,000 HP. So the Crab and the Scorpion both are 12,000 HP when the Crab is stopped. However, that Crab needs to stop right now. That Scuttle, it's not going to work. That Scuttle, there we go, okay. For Flipstip at least, that Scuttle was going to be a major problem. That'd have ruined Flipstip's day. And if the Crab's out of position when the Scuttle explodes, that would still ruin their day somewhat. At this point, Missile Silo come. Oh, nice! Flipstip going for, I guess, an Inferno, trying to just burn out the shield and then burn out the factory. I'm guessing. They might go for double AOS to try to just take out the Jumpbot factory. Oh no, they don't know about the Jumpbot factory. They know it must exist, but they don't know where it is. And they have no real scouting. Scorpion coming in as well for Ball of Doom, because why not? Ball of Doom with a Strider Hub in the center of the map. They're really focused on that center. I mean, that's the thing. Right now, with Ball of Doom, their main weakness is their center focus. If Flipstip. The thing is, Ball of Doom's main weakness is the fact that they're focused in the center. They can be flanked out, they can be attacked from behind, have their main base destroyed, have the Cloaky Boss destroyed, and then kind of get withered away from the back. And Crab was in position. Scuttle did very little. This is working out beautifully for Flipstip. Scorpion has not revealed itself. Flipstip not aware that Ball of Doom has a Scorpion. But yeah, so Ball of Doom is really open from behind. Flipstip could come in, rip apart most of this expansion, take out about 12 metal per second from Ball of Doom. And Ball of Doom is not spending a whole lot, so it actually would be worth it. But the thing is, Ball of Doom is putting so much pressure on Flipstip that Flipstip's not going to do that. There's just too much pressure. Flipstip cannot safely afford to do that. Which really sucks for Flipstip. And the crab gone, but that was two scuttles to get rid of a crab. However, the crab costs like 1,200 or something, so... Oh, 1,600. Yeah, so that was still worth it. That was still worth it by cost. Especially since at this point, Flipstip kind of has to win the cost war regardless. And Ball of Doom Scorpion about to reveal itself. Not quite stunning out Flipstip Scorpion, but still a bad position to be in. Flipstip Scorpion looks like it's about to get surrounded and torn to shreds. What support forces are there? None! With the crab down and the venom's gone, Flipstip support forces are gone. If they lose the Scorpion, that is game. Any more Shredders coming in here? No! And Scorpion down, Flipstip's down, I think. We'll see. They might have figured that they've built up enough, they've rebuilt enough that they can maybe save it. Oh, Shockley, interesting. I suppose if they Shockley the Scorpion, they might be able to get even, but really the Scorpion, for Flipstip, the Scorpion was a huge momentum booster. I mean, Ball of Doom can just make more. But Flipstip can't. They don't have a Strider Hub anymore. They lost the Strider Hub in that attack with the Zeus's, and there's that Firewalker assist I was talking about, but it's a little too late. I mean, it might help with the Scorpion, but honestly, using the Jump Pod plant for a Scuttle wouldn't be a bad idea. Especially with the Scorpion at as low health as it is, that would actually work out nicely. And Shockley... Nope. Where's it hitting? Oh, hitting... What the heck was it hitting? No clue, but Ultimatum coming in just to finish things off. I mean, Ball of Doom not taking any chances here. Flipstip throws in the towel. Pretty good time lasting there, but that Scorpion from Ball of Doom finishing it off. I mean, really, Flipstip was doing a decent job holding momentum. But yeah, like I said, it was just all that pressure. Flipstip couldn't harass around the side easily. Like, maybe they could have sent some fleas around there, but it would have been tough. Like, they'd have taken out these two metal extractors. Actually, they would have taken out the main base, come to think of it. Fleas totally would have taken out the main base. I don't think Ball of Doom would have quite responded in time. The center would have been a bit harder. But yeah, with that much economy destroyed, Flipstip would at least have an economy parity. And yeah, pressure, not a great position, but still, they could push forward at least. And they know that I'm even on economy. If I push forward and get value in combat, then I'm good. But anyway, that was that game. Let's see if I can find a short game. I saw these two games and I thought, oh, this is going to be awesome. Didn't actually check for a third game. Oops. But I mean, that last game was pretty awesome. Flipstip losing their commander was a big blow, though. I mean, it's just... That really slowed down Flipstip's ult to the center. That was a problem. I mean, good on Flipstip for attacking those corners, though. I mean, taking those corners, especially getting rid of that worker there to make the corners easier to secure. Like, Flipstip taking out Ball of Doom's worker to the south really early on, that stopped the southeast expansion from getting taken as easily. Flipstip was able to hold on to it longer. I mean... The thing is, when you're in that position of corners and your opponent's in the center, of course, you kind of want to flank in. But it was rather hard. Gotta say, those Zeus's were causing problems. Not sure what it would be used against that. Probably a bunch of fleas. Zeus's don't have splash damage, actually. The only downside being that Venoms tend to stun out fellow fleas. But yeah, Zeus doesn't have splash damage. So it's really good against smaller, heavy, or, well, against heavy units, like single heavy units, but not great against large groups. And, let's see. I'm not sure what other game there is to do right now, because I didn't really check, and honestly, it's a little bit hard to find a game. Alright, well, that might be it for me. I don't really want to end it on this. I want to have one more game. You know what? Let's just do a game to show off dynamic lighting. Let's have a game, Marquise versus North Chilean G on Onyx Cauldron. I mean, you've seen the lighting before, but it's just a nice showcase game for this stuff. So that'll be up in just a moment. Stay tuned.